Stand and thank the Lord for being here today. I just want to thank the Lord and praise Him for how He has been keeping me this past few months. I was going through a very deep depression, very stressed out kind of time with anxiety and everything. I just felt hopeless. I didn't know what to do. Some days I just didn't feel like doing anything, but I still had to go on because I had family to help take care of. I had to go to Maryland and stay with Sharon and help her and the girls, and then only to come back and start helping my parents again. And I felt like everything was closing in on me because I didn't have time to get myself recuperated or to get myself straight. I was just constantly going, and really it was like a robot because I just did what I had to do because I had to do it. But I want to stand and thank the Lord today that the effectual, fervent prayers of a righteous man or woman availeth much. Because I know a lot of prayers were going up on me, and I still feel them. And I want to thank the Lord that brothers and sisters in Christ are true to his word. When they say they're going to pray for you, they pray.
Amen.
And they don't let you down either, because they feel like they have that obligation to the Lord as well. And I want to read Isaiah 43, verse 2. This verse has really been one that I can go to on a daily basis, one that has really stuck with me. Isaiah 43, verse 2.
Okay.
When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. And I thank the Lord because he has been with me through these troubling times, through these deep waters. And I'm starting to feel a little better. I have a ways to go, but I know that the Lord is not going to leave me.
Amen.
He's going to see me through this time, and no matter how hard it is and how hard it is for me to continue on. I know he's there. He's lifting me up, and he's never going to leave me or forsake me.
Amen.
So I just want to praise him today because he has brought me a long, long way.
Amen.
And I just want to thank the saints for their continued love and prayer.
Amen. God honors his word. That's true. And he was telling us all kinds of things that we needed to do or we should be doing. Talking about the commandments and how we got to follow this and follow that. We got a covenant. We got all of these things. But all of the time, this scripture came up to me. But Brother David and I was trying to keep from, battling this gentleman. We was trying to keep from going. We was just trying to be humble and share the word of God to him and hope that he could see what we were saying. But he could see some things and his eyes was suddenly dim. But anyway, the scripture that I want to share with you is it's a very confident scripture that we have, those that are in Christ. And the scripture is coming from 1 John chapter 5, and it's verse 13. And we have said it, and we have read it, and we have meditated on it, and all these things, but when we really, really look at this scripture, it has such an impact that we can be confident. No matter who we're talking to, no matter what they're going through, no matter what they're trying to say, we need to do.
Amen.
But the word of God is the truth. It said, these things have I written unto you, that ye believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. And, that's a very important scripture to us as believers, because, you know, the scripture tells us our own heart can soon condemn us. It can suddenly condemn us. But it says God is great. So the word of God is such an instrument of strength. It's an instrument of righteousness. It's an instrument of blessing, because in him we know that we have life eternal. A lot of people that's wandering around now, I'm telling you. A lot of people I know, some of them I know they're supposed to be believers, but they are confused. They don't know the whole truth of the word of God. And matter of fact, they just can't accept it. Let's say it like that. They can't accept God for saying, this is the way to eternal life. This is the way to the home that I've prepared for you. And you have it. But,
amen.
You know, in the word of God, we are confident. And I'm going to read the scripture again. It helped me so much. It said, these things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. And I just thank the Lord for his word. I thank him for that. You know, when we do have these oppositions, when we're talking to people, the word of God come back to us. And you know, we are strengthened, and we sit there and we look at them and we might smile at them or laugh at them because we're trying not to cause any confusion or argument. But the whole time I was saying to myself, that's bad. Mm-hmm. That you don't know where you're going to spend eternity. As a matter of fact, Brother David asked the gentleman that. He said, I hope Yeah. If I come up with the right thing. So that tells us that, hey, you unsaved, man. You got to get your life straight. You need to come to Christ. So thank you.
It's some hard times. It's a world really that we're not even familiar with. So many things going on. Doctors changing and people changing. And it's just, you know, you get to the point and say, Lord, what's happening? Do you care? But the Lord gave me this song a long time ago out of the song book. And I love the words. It says, does Jesus care? Oh, yes, he cares. And he wants us to know that in everything that we're going through, he really cares. We can cast all that care on him that we're asking him, does he care? He does care. And the song says, does Jesus care when my heart is pained? Too deeply for mirth and song, as the burdens press and the cares distress, and the way grows weary and long. And we say, does Jesus care? Oh, yes, he cares. I know he cares. His heart is touched with my grief. When the days are weary, my long nights dreary, I know my Jesus cares. Amen. Does Jesus care?
Yes, he does.
When my way is dark, with a nameless dread and fear, as the daylight fades in the deep night shades, does he care enough to be near? Oh, yes, he does. So many times at night, I wake up and can't go back to sleep, and I can hear the Lord speak to me through his word. Pray. I care. I understand. You know, he does. He brings me through some dark, dark nights, some things, some fears and anxieties and anguish that nobody knows but the Lord. And he hears my tears, he sees them, and he comforts me. And I know all of us go through some of those things. And we ask ourselves, Lord, do you care? He does care. I thank you for Jesus caring. Oh, yes, he cares. And I know he cares. His heart is touched with our grief. When the days are so weary, the long nights dreary, I know that my Savior cares. Thank you, Lord.
I would say it like this. Some Christians see and understand, and some Christians do not see and understand. But the objective of all these messages, if we are on the wrong road, is to bring us back on the right road. That's what these messages are all about. And I could be on the wrong road, and the Lord can speak to my heart through these messages and other brother messages and get me back what? On the what? Right road. That's all we're trying to accomplish here, okay? And our main verse is Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 16. Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 16. And what I'd like to do today is go over a review of what we have covered and then get into the message for the day that's on the Revelation. But we'd like to do a review first because we are in critical times and I think this verse says it all. So everybody have Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 16?
Amen.
Okay. All right. Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 16. Let's read that verse together. Redeeming the time because the days are evil. One more time. Redeeming the time because the days are evil. And we need to make good use of our time. Make good use of our time. And I said we'd like to do a review. We'd like to do a review and go back because I want to put in I know Brother Tony does it all the time. He put in a plug for Chat. It comes on Saturday nights. He put in a place for the, if you have family kids, you want them to watch that. And then he said also adults. I want to put a plug in for that too, for the Chat. And the first area I'd like to look at, let me tell you where we are. We're on 3. Let me get my glasses up here. Okay. We're on 3:3. Okay, that's on the outline. Roman number 3. And we're on 3. Okay, on 3. Now, like I said, I want to do a review. I want to do a review.
Brother Cole, excuse me.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you have any more up there? The outline? We don't have any back there.
You don't have any back there? Okay. Might have to run some there. Can we get somebody to run some?
Call out your scriptures, brother, so they can write them down. They got a sheet they can write the scriptures.
Okay. Okay, I can do that. Okay. The first one be, okay, we just went over Ephesians 5:16. Okay. And this says we have an enemy. Enemy. That's what we have an enemy. Anybody know that? We have an enemy? Okay. All right. And we've been over in and we went over into we covered David and the Philistines. We covered the Gibeonites. We covered David last time with the Amalekites. And I'd like to go back and I want to bring the children in. I hear a baby making some noise and that music to my ear. I just want everybody to know that. I like hearing it. I like hearing them babies, amen? Of course, I do want to talk about the children today. And we spoke one time on Deuteronomy. First, let me go over the, Ephesians chapter 6. And it said that we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, is that right? And Brother Tony has been speaking in that area too. We don't wrestle against flesh and blood. And Revelation 12:9 talks about the dragon, the devil, the serpent. And the scripture says in Revelation 12:9 that he deceiveth Stony Creek and Hopewell, Prince George, Surrey, Richmond. Is that what the scripture says in Revelation 12:9? Let's turn to that so we were to make sure we got it right. We may not get too far today, but I want everybody to understand what we're talking about. Revelation 12:9. Everybody have that?
Amen.
Read that verse for me. It was good for all of us to read that because we must believe the scripture. Amen? It said he deceived what? The whole what?
Whole world.
Not just part of the world, but he deceived the whole world. Now, we are in the world, but we're not of the world. So he really had no business deceiving who? He don't have no business deceiving us, but you know he's doing it? Sure, yeah. Okay? But I want to touch the children. And we went back to Deuteronomy. So Daniel, turn to Deuteronomy chapter 6. And look at verse 7. And I want to talk about the children today. We have already gone over this, okay? We have already gone over this. Right? The children. And I'm going to read that verse, Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 7. And thou shalt teach them how? Diligently. And shalt talk of them when thou sittest where?
In thy house.
And when thou walkest by the what?
Way.
And when thou lies down, and that's a full-time job, is that right? And listen, I think I saw an excerpt on TV that said, we come in for your children. Now, let me tell you something, saints. We have to teach our children. I'm talking about the music to my ear right there. That little baby right there. We got to start teaching them now. The children. If we do not teach the children, Satan will teach them. Not only will he teach them, he'll change their bodies. Yeah. Somebody got to help me. Yeah. And don't need your permission. Hey. Somebody got to help me now. We got to teach these children. We're not going to turn them, but Psalm 78 said we got to teach them so they'll teach their children. And that the generation to come will teach their children. What we are seeing now, and really the church is kind of silent a little bit. They're kind of silent a little bit. I know why they're silent. See? The children must be taught the word of God now. And it starts in Genesis. That God created male and female. Somebody got to help me. They are what? Brother Griffin, Brother Johnson, Brother Dawson, Brother Arrington, all the men of God that have come here. I don't think they would have believed what we see now. Who in the world thought that we would have to teach little babies like that now? Because if we do not, Satan will teach them. And when he teaches them, the scripture says in John 10:10, he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Is that right?
Yeah.
Now, so I want to turn over to my glasses up here. Pretty my eyes, you say. I want to turn over to Mark. Now, this is going to happen in the future, but it said, the scripture said the spirit of Antichrist is already here. But he hasn't come on the scene yet. Okay, he ain't come on the scene yet. But I want to Mark 13:12. Mark 13:12. And I'm talking about the, now, we can't take this for granted. Amen? Yeah, we can't take this for granted. And I want to, Mark 13:12, let me see if I can read that. Now the brother shall betray brother. To happiness, joy, and peace.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Or is it death? And the father and the son. And the children shall rise up against their parents and shall cause them to be what?
Yeah.
I didn't see that. I can see that now. Yes, I can. I can see it now. And we haven't even gotten into the future yet. We're going to touch a little bit on that when we get to Revelation. But I actually can see this. I can see the children rising up against their parents when their parents say, no, you can't do that. That's wrong. That's wrong according to the scriptures. I can see them rising up. I actually can see this. And if we cannot see this, the title of the message is, do we see and understand? We did a sermon one time. We said, if we leave out this door, go down to that corner, make a left turn, cross West Street, go by the basketball court, the football field, the church up there. Say we don't cross West Street. Go up, go across the bridge, come down to Halifax Street, there's a church on the right-hand side. Say we don't cross the bridge and go all the way up to Halifax Street. Make a right turn before we get, when we get to that red light, instead of taking 85, we stop at that red light, there's a church in that corner there where Sister Mary told me they went to. Make a right turn at that red light, there's two churches down there. Make a left turn on Farmer Street, there's Johnny Coleman Church up there. Go a few more blocks, make a left, right turn, M Street Church is up there. You said, what are you saying, bro? There's plenty of churches. But none getting done. They come in and hidden the word of God. But they lean in on what? And we're going to get there. Okay? We're going to get there. So, we have an enemy that deceived the whole world. And then we have an enemy that we can't see. Can't see. So what should a person do? Or what should a person say? I need to find out what's going on and who to go to. The person to go to is Jesus Christ. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father but by me. So we left Ephesians and we went to Proverbs 3:5-6. Is that right? Okay. So let's turn there. I think we might be able to quote that. But believe it or not, I'm still trying to learn that verse. Yes, I am. I'm trying to learn that verse. You know why? Because it said, trust in the Lord. We can quote that verse, right? Somebody said I spoke in that verse 2 or 3 weeks.
Years.
So it shows that sometimes the saints don't forget, and it shows that sometimes the saints assume you to forget. Amen? Amen? But that verse said, trust in the Lord. Don't put the trust in man. Because we're not rational against man. Satan using man, as Brother Tony been bringing out. Amen? But it said, trust in the Lord with what? All. Hold on. Let me say it. All. Now, that's growth. Is that right? That's spiritual growth. We're growing. Most of us at the mission have been here a long time. We should be growing a little bit more. Is that right? And thank God for 1 John 1:9, amen? I got wrong, get amen on that, amen?
Amen.
But it said, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. I tried to sing a song up here one day. It said, do you know it all comes down to where your heart is? Is there your whole decision must all begin? I tried to sing that song. But it all comes down to what? Where our heart is. And this is what the scripture says. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. That's where our growth needs to come in. Is that right? Now, but that verse also says this right here. This is one of the plainest verses that you can understand. It said, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not. Everybody see that? Huh? Everybody see that? Do you know some Christians are leaning on their own what? Understand? And some Christians what? Are not. Sometimes we go to verse 6, and sometimes we don't go to verse 6. In all thy ways, acknowledge him. That's what verse 6 says, right? But we want to back up to verse 5. Now, sometimes we might say up here, this is what I think, this is the way I see it, this is the way I believe, this is the way I understand it. And sometimes it might go on top of our head, is that right? But you know what verse 5 says? It says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not unto what? Thy own understanding. Now listen, when we say, this is what I want to say it slow today. This is what I think. I'm about ready to call it the head shakers. Okay? I'm sure you what I mean by it. This is what I think. This is what I believe. And this is the way I see it. And when we get down like that, we are ready to make a stand. I will come up against God's word. That's dangerous. Pride will come up against God's holy word. And I want to tell you how it does. Satan is so smooth that he'll come across the media. Disagree. He'll come across the TV. He'll come across the news channels and some radios. And he'll get us in this area right here. This is what you say about it. You ever listen to the news? They said, what you say about that? They said, this is what I think. This is what I believe. Now, let me tell you what I know. In Matthew chapter 4, when the devil came to the Lord Jesus, did he say, this is what I think?
No.
Did he say it?
No.
He said one thing. He said, it is written. Now, this is God Almighty. This is our Savior. He said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone. Went and got the scripture out of Deuteronomy chapter 8 and verse 3. We think we have an I know degree, and we tell the Lord, this is what I think. He said, he told us it's written. Every time we tell the Lord Jesus Christ, this is what I think. This is what I believe. This is the way I see it. We're playing in the devil's backyard. And we went over, remember we taught on Ahab, Jehoshaphat, and Micaiah. Remember we taught on that?
Right.
Everybody remember that?
Yes.
Okay. What happened to Jehoshaphat? Let me help you out a little bit. Turn to 2 Chronicles. Remember we talked about a man, Ahab said, Jehoshaphat said, there is one man. He said, but I what?
Hate him.
I hate him. Right. He said, I hate him. All right? Mm-hmm. Now, King Ahab is sitting right there. King Jehoshaphat is sitting right there. They said, go get Micaiah. So the messenger that went to get Micaiah, he said, now listen. He said, everybody who spoke good to the king said, we want you to do likewise. This is what Micaiah said. Okay? 2 Chronicles 18, 12 and 13. Okay? So let's turn now. You ought to see these scriptures here, isn't it? You don't get far today, you need to see that. Let me know when you have it.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. Okay. Now, read verse 12 for me.
And the messenger that was sent to call Micaiah spake to him, saying, behold, the words of the prophets declare good to the king with one sentence. Let thy word, therefore, I pray thee, be like one of theirs, and speak thy good.
He told him, said, we want you to speak what?
Good.
Good, right? Now read verse 13.
And Micaiah said, as the Lord lives, even what my God said, that God I speak.
Hold it right there. Do you know that what all of us should be saying?
Yeah.
Yes, we should. He said, I want you to speak something good now to the king. He said, as the Lord lives, what my God said, that will I speak. If we do not do that, then Satan's going to mess with us a little bit. Okay? Now, I'm going to go down and read verse 25. Verse 25. This is the still review. Okay? Verse 25. Then the king of Israel said, take ye Micaiah and carry him back to Ammon and the governor. Okay, the governor of the city. And to Joaz, the king's son. He said, take this fellow back and put him where? In prison. Okay, that's where you got him from, in prison. Okay? Now, verse 26. And say, thus said the king, put this fellow in the prison and feed him with bread and water. Oh, okay, bread or what? So now, they that live godly should do what?
Suffer persecution.
Okay, affliction and with water. And with water of affliction. Okay? Until I return in peace. You know what he said? He said, put this guy in prison until I'll do what? Return what? In peace. In peace. Okay? Just a couple more verses saying. I'm going to review. Okay? Verse 27. And Micaiah said, if thou certainly return in peace, then hath not the Lord spoken by me? He said, if you return in peace, then the Lord hath not what? Okay. Now, where is Ahab and Micaiah, I mean Jehoshaphat? They're sitting right there listening, is that right? They're just like when the brother come up here, we sit right in the congregation and we listen, is that right? Now, he said, Micaiah said, you, in so many ways, he said, you're not coming back. He said, you're coming back, but it won't be in peace. Yeah, you're coming back now. Well, okay, let me read another verse here, verse 28. Okay, help me out. Okay. Verse 28. So the king of Israel and Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah, went up to Ramoth Gilead. Is that right? And we call it a city. What are we talking about? Anybody remember that city? Let me help you out. We're talking about three people. And Jehoshaphat was one of them. They went to the city of Wentville. Anybody remember that now? You don't? Right there. That's why the Lord gave us last time Psalm 106, verse 13. You know what that said?
They soon
forget. And waited not for his counsel. Okay. All right. Okay. We need one more scripture here. A couple more. Okay. Verse 29. And the king of Israel said unto Jehoshaphat, I will do what?
Disguise.
Put it right there. I know you remember now. Yeah, I know you remember now. Amen. Everybody remember that?
Yeah.
But there's another word we need to pay attention to. You know what he said? He said, I will. Okay? I will. He said, I will disguise myself, but you do what?
Go on battle.
No, read it from the scripture.
read
verse 29 for me.
And the king of Israel said to Jehoshaphat, I will disguise myself and will go to battle.
Okay. Now, when Micaiah told everybody where Jehoshaphat, we said that Micaiah and Jehoshaphat loved the Lord, is that right? As two Christians, is that right? One went that way and one went that way, is that right? Is that what we said? Okay. So we can love the Lord, but if we lean on our own understanding, we can go away from God's word. Is that right? I can't get on that. Okay? Now, when we got to verse 29, I know what you said. There's no way in the world I'll fall for that. The king said, I'm going to disguise myself, and you put your robe on. I know what you said when we taught on it. That must be a...
Yeah.
There's no way in the world I'm going to fall for that. He should not have fell for when Micaiah said, if you return in peace, then the Lord has not spoken to me. Now, if I would have said, now I said, did you hear what the man of God said? The man of God said, you're not coming back. Okay. All right. He still went to Ramoth Gilead. On the way to Ramoth Gilead, he said, listen, I'm going to disguise myself. But you put your robe on. I said, what you say? I ain't going with you. But did the Christian go with him?
Yep.
Who saved him? The Lord. Is that right? Do you know we like that? Huh? And when you look at verse 29, you see how ridiculous it is.
Yes.
Am I right? Satan fooled over the same tricks. And when the Lord shows it to her, you say, hey, how in the world did I fall for that? You know what I'm going to say? Now, 29, chapter 9, verse 19. Okay.
Say that again.
Okay. That was 18, right? Chapter 18?
Yes.
We got chapter 19.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to stop right there. Now, this is still review. All right. Still review, right? Now, 2 Chronicles 19, verse 2. Okay? Now, and Jehu, let me make a point right here. One of our problems today, there are no Jehu messages. There's no Jehu messages. Okay? If we had Jehu messages, you know, well, a lot of us not getting back on the right road. Okay? Verse 2. Jehu, the son of Hanani, the seer, went out to meet him and said to King Jehoshaphat. And when we taught this here, we said this is one of the most powerful questions that you can ask a Christian. And that question is right here in verse 2. Shouldest thou help the ungodly and love them that hate the Lord? That is powerful. Do you know there's a strong possibility over in Proverbs 3:5, when we lean on our own understanding, there's a possibility, a strong possibility, that we can help the ungodly. And we've been sitting in church. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Good, ain't it? Then we walk right out those doors and lean on our own understanding. When we done heard the word of God up here. The word of God said, this is the way walk ye in it. You said, but I know what I'm doing. Amen. Head shakers. I know what I'm doing. This is what I believe. How in the world that come across? That come across from the television and stuff like that. Now, King Ahab said, I will disguise myself. Anytime we use what I think, what I believe, what I see, we are doing what I call the J3C. The J3C, the J stands for the book of James. Okay? The 3 stands for chapter 3. And the C stands for the cell phone. Now, you know what chapter 3 is about that tone. Is that right? That's a hard thing to do what?
Control,
is that right? So what Satan does, he uses us. And we call the guy a ministry. Hey, man, what's going on? This is what I believe. Yeah, you believe that? I believe it too. Then the sister, oh, what you believe? I did what I believe. This is what I think. Ain't nobody got no scriptures nowhere, but this is what I think. Yeah, they're doing the J3C. Amen. All that wisdom is from the earth. Is that right? All that wisdom from the earth is not from where?
Above.
Amen? So, let's see what time it is here. What time it is? I'm going to go over here. One thing, we're not going to finish. That's one thing. But I want to close with this here. This is just a review right here. And so just bear with me. Just bear with me a minute, saints. Let me get my stuff all right. I tell you what, let's see. Turn to Isaiah chapter 14. And we're going to close out here. Okay. Yeah. Pray the Lord for 1 John 1:9. Amen?
Amen.
Right, okay. Okay. I want to back up. Everybody got Isaiah 14? We're going to close up with this. We're not going to finish, all right? Okay? Now, when we start talking about what I think, what I believe, this is where I sit, I'm not going to go to Romans 3:4 today. This is the way I see it. When Satan gets us in that area, we're playing in his backyard. The word I, that Brother McKenzie scripture he gave us today, John 3:30, he must increase in what I must do?
Decrease.
But when we over in Proverbs 3:5 and the Lord said, don't lean on your own understanding, and then we tell the Lord what I think, what I believe, where we get that from? We got to get it from somewhere. We get it from the TV. And all the newspapers, they haven't told you yet about Revelation 12 9. No, they haven't. I listen to the news too. They haven't told you that. The Lord said, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not unto thy what? Own understanding. What I think, what I believe, this how I feel. Do you know those are fighting words? We'll come up against God Almighty, the Lord Jesus Christ, and tell him what I think. Hear his word and go out and do what I think, what I believe. That's the wrong way to do it. When we lean on our own understanding, we're playing in the devil's backyard. And he will help us to help the ungodly. In other words, he's recruiting when we do the J3C. He said he's recruiting who? Christians. He said he can't do that. If we lean on our own understanding, he can. Is that right?
Amen.
Sure he can. I'm talking about myself too. Right? And it's not, you know what? Most of the Christians, they don't mean to do wrong because they love the Lord. Is that right? That's Jehoshaphat. Jehoshaphat loved the Lord, is that right? But he got himself right. He got himself right. And that's all we're saying. That's all we're saying. Okay? Now, when we do what the Lord has told us not to do, we're playing in the devil's backyard. Look at verse 12. Read verse 12 for me. Okay. Verse 13 says, but thou hast said in thy what? And verse 14.
I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High.
I will. Oh, Ahab said that. He said, I will disguise myself. You know, we know who we're using it. Satan was using it, is that right? When we come here, you know how many I wills in there? It's five. Five I wills. This is what Satan said. What he would do. All these eyes are fake eyes. They're not real. The Lord Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man, no woman, no boy, no girl come to the Father but by me. I am the way. We can easily fall in the devil's backyard when we do not hold to what the Lord has told us to do. Now, when the Lord Jesus Christ tell the devil, it is written, I know he got to tell him the same thing. Where all that I will come from there? What I think, what I believe. We'll check the world next time. Check the world next time. All that stuff is out of the world. He said, man, it is written. But do you know the devil came back and said, it is written? That's why we need to come to God's house. That's why we need to get in God's word daily. That's why we mentioned about the chat. You got to teach these children the word of God. And if you don't teach them, they become the antimony, I'm somebody else. And there's no scriptural foundation for it. Satan had put a zipper around our mouths. And many churches will not preach the word of God because they got themselves entangled with the affairs of this life. The children, marriages, young people, you got to hold to the word of God. When we get in the world, we haven't touched Revelation. We got to get my stuff up here. Yeah, we got to stop. We'll pick up next time. This is just a review. We already covered it there. Question. He said, I'll be like the, he said he want to be like the Most High. Said it is hot. No fake eyes. Not but one God.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus Christ, isn't it?
Amen.
Okay? So if we're on the wrong road, we need to get what?
On the right road.
On the right road. Amen.
Amen.
But there may be someone that is not saved yet. You want to give your heart to Jesus. Believe in the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. He is the way, the truth, and the life. There's no other way but through Jesus. And you say, I believe that he died on the cross, that he was buried, that he rose from the dead. I want to be saved today. You can pray a prayer like this. Dear God, I am a sinner and I'm lost. And I want to be saved. I believe you died on the cross for my sin, that you were buried, that you rose from the dead. Lord Jesus, come into my heart and save me. Then believers, you say, you know, I've been leaning on my own understanding in many things. Some things I go to the Lord, and some things I lean on my own understanding. But when I lean on my own understanding, when the Lord has told me in the word, don't do that, I want to ask the Lord today, forgive me. Thank God for 1 John 1:9. I want to ask the Lord to forgive me and help me get on the right road. That's what I want to ask the Lord to do. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we do thank you, Lord, for your word. We ask you, Lord, to undertake. We all love you, Lord. And many times, Lord, we lean on our own understanding when you say, don't lean on our own understanding. Many times we do. We've seen it from the scripture. We ask you, Lord, to help us, Lord. Lord, that we may be able to redeem this time because the days are evil. In Jesus' name I pray and give thanks. Amen.
Amen.
I come that you might have love.